The next phrase is like, I don't have to, you have to, but I don't. And the inner child expects that other people will do something for him, but he's not gonna do anything in return. For example, a woman who does not want to play with her kids or spend time with them, she can say, mommy's tired, mommy's busy, mommy does not feel good, but you should love your mommy, you should understand that your mommy is tired, you should be nice to your mother, you should behave well. So she is expecting from children a lot of things, but in return, she is not giving them enough love, enough attention. And these children will grow up and they will not be able to mature. They will not be able to create happy, healthy relationship because they did not get enough love. So do you see how this mechanism is going through generations, from mother to children, from children to their children? Another example, a father who leaves his family and believes that his kids will be better without him. My parents divorced when I was 11. And when my father moved to another city, he did not call me, he did not visit me, he did not send any gifts, anything for my birthday. I did not, he just disappeared. When I was 16, I've met my father and I asked him, I said, like, why you never called, not even on my birthday? And he told me this. He said, I thought this is better for you. I thought that if I'm gonna visit you, it's gonna be more painful. So I decided that when you grow up, you will understand it. Again, you have to understand me, but I don't have to do anything for you, right? So the father basically is saying, you are my child and you have to understand me. I could not create a relationship with your mother. Our marriage was falling apart. So I decided to move to another city. You have to understand me, but I'm not gonna do anything for you. This is the inner child. This is a selfish mechanism of the inner child. Another example, a father who visits kids twice a month instead of raising them. So instead of paying attention, spending time with your kids, instead of raising your kids, a father becomes like a weekend father. So I'm a good one. I'm gonna take kids to the movie. I'm gonna have fun with them. I'm gonna play with them. And the mother is gonna be the bad one because she's gonna raise them. She's gonna teach them. She's gonna say no to them. And I'm gonna be a vocational father. I'm the good one. You should love me the way I am. I'm not gonna teach you. I'm not gonna spend time with you only for fun stuff. Another example, a grandmother or grandfather who spoiled grandkids and breaks the rules that parents create. A grandmother can say something like, oh, I don't have to teach your kids. I don't have to raise your kids. You should do it. And she's right. Parents should teach their kids. Parents should be responsible for the kids, for their kids, right? But at the same time, grandmother does not have the right to break the rules, because when she is breaking the rules that mother father created, the kids is not gonna follow those rules and it's gonna be in conflict. So the grandmother who is saying, I want to be a good one, I don't have to do anything, I don't have to follow your rules, I don't have to teach kids, I'm gonna spoil kids, they have to love me. And in order for them to love me, I have to spoil them.